This app can't open? Deception. What are you doing? Come on. Come on. Hello, Ken, everyone. It is your Black Knight. And today they're releasing the definitive editions, and I've just got no interest, really. Look, I haven't saved a game since 2010. June 9th of 2010. I just go in, I fool around, and I exit. I haven't really advanced the game. I've played it since then, but here I am. I'm at the point where, you know, do I have more money in this game than I have in GTA Online? I do. That's $96 million. Wow. That's impressive. That's impressive. Of course, there's not much to buy in this game. Money in this game is really just for points. Okay, kids, how many of you out there even know why that tape is there? Like, do you even know what that's a tape? Do you know what that symbol is? I remember we used to save games to tape. So I'm going to keep this look. The classic look. And you can see the place is messed up from partying. Yum. Can get bullets if I need them. I'm not shooting nothing. I'm just going to walk around. Grab money for no reason. I'm probably not going to save this either. This is the game that I have. It's a game I've beaten already. And it wasn't an easy game to beat. I mean, you know, it was tricky. I'm proud to have beaten it. I enjoy going back to a world where I have two Love Fist limousines saved. This is back when you could save any car. And I mean, I don't think you can load your save files into the new remasters, and that's really one of the reasons I'm not going to get it. As far as GTA, interesting thing, I thought I had a GTA 3 in Steam. I don't. I don't know if that was just never available. I would have bought it when I got this, because I have the rest of them. There was a pack that you could get. Did they take that away from me? I mean, that's kind of odd. Let's take a look. Let's go up to the car dealership here briefly. I mean, there's a lot of things that are kind of odd. I mean, if they hadn't, you know, I've never loaded any of the mods for this. I was never really into the modding community for this game. That, you know, make it all nice and pretty. But I mean, at GTA, they've taken down the original version, so you can't buy them, you know, digitally anymore. Alright, number one. Sued everybody so that you can't get the mods to make it look pretty anymore. Which, honestly, it makes you wonder why they needed to make a definitive edition, because if there were mods that made it as pretty as a definitive edition, which is the only reason they'd have them taken down, then you could just sell the old one and let the mod guys make you money. The definitive edition is one of the stupidest things you could possibly do. But me, I'm old school. Hell, you know, on a gamer basis, I'm old. So, I mean, I don't care. This is good enough for me. And, like, you know, if I get the new game, you know what I don't have? I don't have all the police cars already saved. Because you can't even do that in GTA Online. This is something you could save anything. I'm going to show you. You're going to say anything? Yes, anything. I mean, a couple of minutes. This was significant for something. I don't remember what. There was some mission that I got through. If you see, like, a really mundane car in a garage in this game, that's because there was some mission, and I kept it for sentimental reasons. Let's go to the proof you can get anything. Part of it. But I mean, you know, if Rockstar hadn't, oh, by the way, let's look at this. We have to look at what cars are here, because they're significant. in history here. Just having the... check it out. There's the Sabre Turbo. I have a Sabre Turbo painted just like this in my garage in DTA Online. The original Deluxo that doesn't fly unless you hit the jump just right. The Sentinel, which is now the Sentinel Classic. All right, we have the Hot Ring Sabre. Obviously, where is this car in game? Where do you know? I mean, there's some cars that do similar, that fit a similar role. But I mean, this Sandmaster's Cup. What was it even called? The Sand King. This is their Sand King. So that's what the Sand King was—a short wheelbase Bronco kind of thing. And now it's a pickup truck. Well, I guess it's much lift, but certainly not as much zip. I mean, this Sand King zips. I mean, at least it feels like it zips in this game. Maybe it wouldn't feel like it zipped if you put it in GTA Online, but... this isn't your driveway, pal. You gotta love these cars. Yeah, if they hadn't... you know, if Rockstar hadn't been so snotty about the whole thing... where, you know, oh no, we're gonna get rid of the modders, and we're not gonna let you buy the old game, and we're not gonna... you have to buy this one, we need to make money. Are you that insecure, Rockstar? You know, that's all such a turn-off. I have San Andreas. I can play the original San Andreas if I want. I've never gotten a chance to play it. I've never, you know... once GTA Online came out, it was kind of like, well, do you want to go back and do San Andreas? It seems like it's a heavier, you know... once you start out, it's like, you know that, you know... you're avenging your mother's death. It was always a little too heavy for me, you know? I'm sure there's humor in it, because by Vice City, they perfected the need for humor. I don't think GTA 3 had enough humor in it, and that's why it didn't hold my attention. GTA 4 definitely didn't have enough humor. So that's why it didn't hold my attention there either. Ooh, we get the soiree clothes. That's right, we can't go into the strip club here. Except for certain missions, right? Wrath Hills. Oh, wait, it's a different one. It's the, we have, it's one of the businesses, I think, is we have that one. Is this just the clothes? It's not where I'm thinking I'm going. Alright, everything's so pink here. Been a while since I played it, but... we've got our Raphael suit. So we could do... you can totally do the pose out coming out of the, I'd say we can totally do the pose coming out of the... the hotel here. But you really can't turn and face this way. Like if I have to face for the hotel, I can't see it. So, you know, maybe when they added the GTA controls, you can now face yourself in front of the ocean view, and that's a big thing. Sentinel and Hermes. Not a Sentinel classic here. This was back when it was becoming a classic. Yeah, but if they hadn't been as snotty about the whole thing, if they hadn't said, no, the only GTA Vice City that's going to exist is the new one. We're erasing history, and we're going to make it so that you can't have a modded version of the old one. Like, if you're worried about that, maybe just do a better job on it so that people are impressed enough that they have to have it no matter what's out there, you know? I don't like being told what I have to get. You know, this is... I happen to have this in Steam. I don't know where my GTA 3 is gone. I mean, I didn't have it. Maybe I didn't get it because I wasn't real happy with it back in the day, but I mean... or maybe it just wasn't part of whatever pack I bought when I got these. I don't know. Whee! Trying to run people over. So I'm not, you know, what I'm basically saying here is I'm not going to be doing anything with these new versions for a while here. Maybe at some point I'll say, you know, I've heard enough good things. Yeah, I'll dip into it. But no, I'm not going to be part of the initial rush. And I might never get them. Because honestly, if I'm going to do GTA stuff, you know, why wouldn't I just spend my time doing, you know, the, can you go into the mall without being in a mission? Yes, you can. Okay. For the time of day, it's empty. But there was a card you could take here, wasn't there? Wasn't there like a win this car kind of thing? You could get coveralls here. You could buy stuff. There are gangs hanging about. To a certain extent. Oh, look, see, that's why I blew up the Tarbush Cafe. It's all askew. And some of the sign's down, but some of the chairs are still just, you know, didn't do much damage, I guess. Has anyone seen my attaché? Let's see, vice points. So I'm on the other side of the building now. But this is the Vice City universe in which I have won. I have gotten bunches of cars. I have to show you the proof that you can save anything. That's how we're gonna wrap this up here. We have to drive around. I don't know that I'd want to do it all over again. You know, it's like I like Vice City, but do I want to play through it again and have the same experiences right now? Some of those are really annoying missions. They took over and over and over, and I had, you know, maybe I should have more patience now. I just ran that guy over, didn't I? Let's see, where am I going? Where am I going? Okay, so that's a save point. I haven't saved in 11 years. Okay, here we are. You loop back out this way. Still can't believe this is the Sand King versus the Sand King we have now. I guess it's about right. Oh, the club. Yes, yes, the club. We've got to go clubbing. See, but this is enough happiness for me. And the fact that it's not you know, real sharp graphics, that lets you, you know, fill in the, it's, you know, it, there's an endearingness to it. Girl on girl action there. The YMCA guys here, that's well thought out. Everything was well thought out. Not even bothering them, I'm not gonna save. I'm not advancing much here. Go over this way. I'm trying to think. I will admit, a map would be nice. Yeah, you know, where you could, you know, have some GPS. But you know what? Guess what we didn't have in the 80s? Oh, there's my house. Okay, that's what I'm looking for. Because that's, we have to get back in that direction. Now, as I recall, this used to be. There should be. A jump here. I could have swore somewhere, I mean, it's on the other side of this thing here. There used to be a place where you could jump. Jump across. He is on the other side there. There's the building all blown up. Eh, we'll just drive. Yeah, it's behind me. Okay. I don't know if the Sand King can make it anyway. It's not that zippy. dune buggies and all kinds of stuff. So now we're going to turn this way. I wonder if I have the radio on. It's usually set to VCPR, so I don't have my headphones on. Can we make a cut through? No, that won't be. I'll get me shoot myself shot through there. Okay, let me just grab a headphone. See, am I playing radio? No, the radio's off. Good. We got that going for us. Yeah, I turned that off in the settings years ago when I was making videos. If I'm playing the game, the radio's, yeah, that's a key thing. Radio's so good in this game, but DCMA is so bad in this world. Old YouTube wouldn't have cared. Alright, that wasn't the turn, okay. Give me a chance here. I haven't played this game in a while. We rough up the Sand King. And then here we are. So this is the proof that you could really, truly save anything in this game, part of the game. Ta-da! You have no idea how much work this was. Because I put the tank in there first. I think. I might have a video of this someplace. But I had to snuggle the... I had to get like a vehicle and push, or me physically myself, push the helicopter in just to keep it. I have no idea how I get it out. If I take the tank and move it at all, it bumps the helicopter and the helicopter just explodes. So these are just there to have. That's all they're there for, is to have. But I have them. Mine. And most people have tanks, really. Aren't they just to have to look at, really? I mean, you know. Helicopters probably not, but you know, this is an Apache. I mean, come on. There's a couple other cool things, I mean, around. As I recall, all these were very mission-specific. Saved my butt somewhere along the line. And if we go in through the rooftop access... It's suddenly pouring rain! We get all these weapons. As I recall, the helicopter controls are completely different. So, like... Well, maybe they're not. Let's see. Okay, so that's not different. That's that way and that way. This turns. Okay, that's the difference. It reverses your turn. It's a little different. Whee! It's Maverick time. At least I'm not getting wet. You say you go back to land. Nope, you've already got a replacement helicopter. This game kept you stocked. But then again, you don't really need a landing pad, right? You just... Yeah. Right on the edge. Yeah, you know, I mean, truth be told, if Rockstar hadn't been so snotty about everything and said, alright, no, this is the only way you're going to experience Vice City. You know, it's kind of the same feeling as when you couldn't watch the original Star Wars. Oh no, the modified, upgraded George Lucas's true vision versions of it. Like, those aren't my favorite versions. My favorite versions are the ones from when I was a kid. You know? Oh, well, you're just a slave to nostalgia. Yeah, so what's your point? So I think I'm not going to get, maybe I'll eventually get them, but I'm not getting them right now. I'm a slave to nostalgia. And, you know, again, I think they did the little guy wrong there when they screwed all those people who spent years working on mods to make this better. That would make them more money because other people bought Vice City because those mods existed. And then, you know, you stab them all in the back, you strip the game, all the games from online. Yeah, you know, it's all, there's a bad taste there. So don't be looking for any, you know, what they call it, the definitive edition. Don't look for any definitive edition videos on this channel. That's for other people to do. Other people, that's their job. Other people, that's their job. Their livelihood is YouTube videos of GTA-ness. And not me. I got a day job. Don't get me wrong. That's their work. They work at that probably more hours per day than I do. But, hey. That's life. Yeah, I'm not doing it. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, this is your Black Knight. You can't control a helicopter. My instinct is to immediately to control it like it's... Let's get this down. Like it's one from GTA, and it's not the same. See, if you got the remastered, then you could control it the same way. Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. This is your Black Knight. Have a great night.